fine Bordeaux and smooth as an Aztec's obsidian kiss. My penis is a lighthouse on the rocky shoals of uncertainty. A crimson pirate probing the shoals of indecision. A jolly Roger stuck in a bar. A flying Dutchman dissolving the indifferent Sargasso Sea. My Venus is an amazing creature with little birdie wings, a golden crested head, streamlined with dorsal fins, independent suspension, and driver-side airbags. My Venus is noble as Lancelot, sterling as Camelot, wise as Solomon, strong as Goliath, cunning as King David, and about as reliable as Lou Costello. My Venus is indomitable, long-range and invincible, a magnificent traveler, intrepid as Magellan, reading magazines between connecting flights. My Venus, a cherished jubilee, a proud Napoleon, a humble Twinkie, just another filigree confection on the boundless buffet of Bacchus. My penis is a religion, a minaret calling the faithful to prayer, the wreck of a ruined cathedral after the battle smoke clears. My penis stands for something that has come and gone, the living will of a bygone age, a legacy proclaimed, the plow that broke the plains and sowed a blizzard of seedlings, flooding the prairie basins with legion upon legion of me. My penis is carved from diamond willow, hard yet workable, resilient and pliable, a good sturdy stick. My penis walks to work and packs a hearty lunch like a common man. My penis is much like the Hindenburg, impressive when inflated, but glorious in flames. My penis is electric like an eel, magnetic like a pole, atomic like a submarine, hydraulic like a fountain, and pneumatic like a drill. My penis is also a vegetable. My penis craves approval and needs the nod from a thousand lovely lovelies or the short stroke from the miserable few. I don't care. My penis is a credit card accepted at a billion locations worldwide. If I can only pay the bill. Ah, but my penis is an incorrigible boy, firing his pistol and jumping for joy. My penis can be cavalier, a cocky rustic dandy at a bustling country fair. But my penis has grown weary with many promises to keep, and so many miles to go before he gets to sleep. And yet to sing of us now to such degree might confuse hubris with apology. But as time takes its toll and follows nature's decree, I must ask just once more, would you like to come closer? And touch it, please.